but I have absolutely no idea what any of that's about.
We're having a discussion about it, but I'm
going to. Let's do this.
I'll get another chair, yeah?
Yeah, lovely. We've got a play sign, Charlie.
Got a play sign,
yeah?
Yep,
can
you hear it? We'll go for it.
What's your name? It puts the away team players.
American football.
I'm going to switch to it.
American football have it first, don't they?
Do they really? Is that what they do?
Yeah, it'll be. They have it so the away team's playing at.
Thank you.
Yeah. big fist pump, yeah. Sorry, I brought the dog up as well, which sounded like a great and fun idea, but now I'm kind of thinking this will be an interesting question with the dog.
Yeah, yeah.
Once again, a very good afternoon. You're currently joined the Lewis Blind and Bedingham Brass Band. Kickoff is at 2 o'clock. And please help yourself to classic burgers and chips up at the Chuckwagon in the top corner near the beach huts. And fantastic pies, including plenty of vegan fare down at the hatch by the bar. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
much to earthquake drummers. To the earthquake drummers, the teams will be coming out about 5 weeks' time, and it's free to be a mascot at Lewis FC, so if you want to come on with the teams, then please go to the bottom steps where the teams come on, and you can come on with the players. Thank you very much.
Welcome along to the Dripping Pan Conti Cup action between Lewis and Crystal Palace, getting underway in about 5 minutes' time. Welcome to all of you listening across the internet, including in New York, where we have a special screening this afternoon here in the UK, early hours, of course, of the morning in the United States of America, in a bar, no less, as well, where there are West Ham and Liverpool supporters clubs, and those two teams are also playing each other. So it's obviously going to be a very lively afternoon. The Conti Cup, very intriguing as far as Lewis are concerned. We've got big games coming up as well against the likes of Chelsea and Spurs over the coming weeks. Lewis unbeaten in the league and getting their cup campaign underway in about 5 minutes' time. A very special afternoon as well. It is the swan song of Katie Macca McIntyre, who will start in central defence this afternoon. I'll give you the team news in just a moment. Breezy conditions. We've had a little bit of light rain here down in the south of England, and don't forget to get involved with us via Twitter as well. Spoiler alert though, if you are watching across the internet, you may well find that Twitter is just a few minutes or so ahead due to a delay of 30 seconds to a minute or so on this particular stream. So let's make sure we don't spoil any goals by inadvertently breaking them on Twitter first. Lewis fans, though, of course, won't be complaining if that happens throughout the afternoon and we can get a comfortable win. Crystal Palace, the visitors, looking to bounce back from a heavy 6-0 defeat to one of the favourites in the Women's Championship, Aston Villa, last time out. Lewis got a late victory of their own away at Coventry, and Zoe Ness, the hero or heroine in that game, was the goal scorer in the last minute and starts up front this afternoon. In terms of the team news then, as promised, both sides making a number of changes this afternoon, with it being a cup match, and Lewis therefore will have a couple of debutants making their first full start for the club, including Aitor Croft, both of them.
Old school, it's from behind the shed to the left of the goal, and
and it makes for a very dramatic, iconic and unique way to start a football match. And I can see to my left, and you will also see in just a moment, the sides lining up on the banks and about to come down some grassy looking steps and onto this impeccable field, which has had a shower over the last half an hour or so, so we should have quite a silky surface ahead of kickoff in just a few minutes time. Kickoff then about to get underway, and it's Lewis FC against Crystal Palace in the Conte Cup. Do join us and get involved across social media, particularly Twitter. Ben Jacobs with you for full match commentary, and we'll hopefully have some surprise guests along the way. Katie McIntyre's final game as a Lewis FC player and professional footballer, as ever she has the captain's armband, and she is about to lead out Lewis FC for this cup game against Crystal Palace. Settle down and then we'll get underway, and I'll also reiterate that team news just in case the loud drumming was anyway detrimental to your hearing. The two lineups are certainly a great atmosphere here at the Dripping Pad. We're very much looking forward to a cacophony of noise and hopefully goals as far as the home team are concerned on the field as well. It's also an open mascot policy here, which is a wonderful idea, so Lewis fans actually have the opportunity, and Crystal Palace fans as well, to come onto the field and walk out with the teams at their own leisure, and they can literally decide at a split second to head over to that far corner and walk out with the teams, which is a nice touch, and it helps keep everybody involved and engaged in the football here at the Dripping Pan. There's the round of applause for Katie McIntyre in her last game as Lewis captain before she retires. And no doubt she will leave to a guard of honour come the full-time whistle. So once the tannoy dies down and the team news is announced here to the crowd at the Dripping Pan, by the looks of things around about 250 or so, we'll start our commentary and I'll run through the team news for you once again as well. Good afternoon and thanks for listening wherever you are. We'll be getting underway in just a couple of minutes time.
To Macca, of course. Thank you.
So just about to get underway once again to reiterate, this is McIntyre's last ever game as a professional footballer and thus Lewis captain. She will be given a rapturous round of applause at any point really when she touches the ball, but also at the end of the match too, where hopefully she'll bow out with a victory. We are expecting a guard of honour and we'll bring you that as well. McIntyre Ajax starts in a familiar position in central defence. Fran Alonso fielding a 4-2-3-1. Izzy Foster comes in between the sticks, partnering McIntyre in defence with Caitlin Hayes. We've got a debut start for Annie Timoney and Sophie O'Rourke as well across the back. Ellie Noble in midfield with Emma Jones, the Welsh attacking midfielder, and also Emily Donovan, Amy Taylor too, and Ellie Noble. That's the five-woman midfield. Effectively, two of them will hold, three of them are attacking midfielders. Emma Jones, we expect to be the one to float wide and cut inside, and up front by herself in this 4-2-3-1 is the Scottish international and former Durham striker Zoe Ness. Crystal Palace looking to bounce back from a 6-0 defeat to Villa last time out in the Women's Championship. Field a 4-4-2. They make six changes. Emma Gibbon in goal, Annabelle Johnson, Hazel McKenzie, Amy Goddard, and Nicole Pepper across the back. Bianca Baptiste, Andrea Georgiou, Ashley Goddard, and Aoife Hurley in midfield. And the former Lewis strikers Cheryl Casal and Magda Masengo up front in a 4-4-2 for the visitors. Crystal Palace in an unfamiliar white kit. Lewis, as ever, in their home red and black. About to get underway then, Crystal Palace will kick things off. And again, look out for Maka, wearing number 4, and the captain. It is her last game in professional football, and those drums and this loud, vibrant Lewis crowd sure to give her a great send-off. So underway here, Welsh flags flying in the background, as well as a few different nationalities, in fact, including Scotland, representative of all the different Lewis players. One of the most multicultural players, though, is actually on the other side, Emma Gibbon, between the sticks. She's only 20. She is a Welsh under-19 international. It was, of course, until she turned 20, but they can't play that final year when they are 1 year too old as well. But she was actually raised in Australia and played for Brisbane Roar as well. So a few players, actually, that are young and talented on both sides that wouldn't normally get a start that we'll get a look at this afternoon, and it'll be interesting to see how they do. A chance for some of these Lewis players in particular to impress manager Fran Alonso. Lewis in good form as well, remember unbeaten in the Women's Championship. Songo with a first touch from Dean, did well to work that infield, but here's Maka's first touch to that right hand side. Ness is floating on the left and calling for it. Noble finds her. Overlap here for Sophie O'Rourke, but Ness is clipped and no advantage played. So Lewis with the first opportunity from deep in. Free kick just inside their own half. Ellie Noble standing over the ball. A warm welcome to our viewers in New York as well. We've got a special screening very early. Thanks for joining us. Also up for West Ham Liverpool as well. A little too strong on that occasion from Noble. Safely into the hands of Emma Gibbon. Conti Cup, very important campaign for Lewis. Not just on the field, but to draw a crowd here. Famous half-time pies, those earthquake drummers, and the likes of Chelsea and newly promoted Spurs will be coming up against Lewis. Chelsea in particular, who will be coming down to the dripping pan to gain this unique experience of football and culture as well. Emma Jones picks up that errant ball, and Palace get it safely away through Georgiou. Down the line looking for Magda Masengo. Tricky conditions in the sense that we thought we were going to get quite severe showers. It started very humid, then we did get a little bit of rainfall, and now it's breezy but humid and dry. Fran Alonso unsure what to wear, so he's gone for a sort of grey and green look with a light jumper on. Most of his coaching staff in tracksuits though. The umbrellas, when we get into the second half, they have to come out. Almost given away there. Lewis get away with one and now can start their own attack down the left-hand side. Excellent pressure though from Bianca Baptiste, the former Arsenal player for Palace, but Lewis still have the ball. So round of applause from the home crowd here from Ellie Noble. Pretty speculative though from that kind of distance, especially because with her right foot she tried to pass it into the near corner, and Emma Gibbon wasn't troubled. Tackle coming in from Annabelle Johnson. Dean Davenport, incidentally, another interesting figure, manager of Crystal Palace women. Marcelo Bielsa likes to sort of squat down on a little bench or water cooler through the majority of the match. If you do catch it on the camera, he's wearing a blue mac. Just in case it does come down with rain. As Palace win the first corner of the match, Bianca Baptiste deflecting the ball off McIntyre. So the Lewis captain involved early on, and that was an important block because the ball was heading towards a dangerous area. Nicole Pepper, the former Chelsea player, to take this outswinging corner. Dinked up early test for Izzy Foster. Lewis's usually reserved goalkeeper shows strong composure there under pressure to gather the ball.
Hey Eddie!
Conti Cup, by the way, if you are unfamiliar, consists of two groups, with the top teams going through to a knockout stage. Chelsea and Spurs amongst some of the big guns in with Lewis. Amy Taylor unable to find Emma Jones. Ashley Goddard trying to use her strength. She's got excellent balance and physicality. That pass, though, nice idea. A little bit too strong for Baptiste. Plenty of space for Lewis, particularly on this near left-hand side. Palace starting very central with limited width, trying to pack the midfield. But that could allow Lewis opportunities coming forwards and on the counter-attack as well, particularly down the channel. Six minutes gone, 0-0 at the Dripping Pan. Goddard for Palace, forced backwards. Haven't seen too much of Masengo. A regular for Palace over the last four or five seasons, and usually gets into double figures in terms of goals as well. Intended target was Baptiste. She's seen plenty of the ball. Now it's with Johnson. Down the line again for Baptiste, a little heavy. Palace, though, will have a throw-in midway inside the Lewis half. The visitors have started in a relatively confident and composed manner, disciplined shape. Sengo, though, every time she's touched it, has largely been forced out wide on that right-hand side, where she's far less of a threat. Main assets are being able to hold the ball up centrally with her back to goal. Use her physicality when she's out wide. Her delivery and pace should be something that the Lewis back line can deal with in less threatening areas. Kurt goes long. Couldn't quite get enough elevation on the ball on that occasion. Here's Donovan. Back towards Ellie Noble, who had plenty of time but put her goalkeeper in a spot of bother there. But Rourke clears the danger well, though. Really. entirely composed by the 20-year-old. Now given away once again, a little sloppily. Palace will have a great opportunity to take the lead, and they do. It's the danger woman, Magda Masengo. And an early blow for Lewis with just 8 minutes gone. It is Magda Masengo who turns 29 this week. And that's an early birthday present for the London-born striker. Lewis nil, Crystal Palace 1 here in the Conti Cup. Super delivery in as well by Ashley Goddard. Laid it on a plate for Masengo, and all she had to do was make clean contact. And Dean Davenport's Palace have the early lead. Cheers as well around the dripping pan, telling you that plenty of Palace fans have made the journey down as well, about an hour and 20 minutes from the centre of London. And now Lewis have to make sure that they keep their composure here. Masengo again, this is the kind of thing she can do with her physicality. It's a super tackle though from Caitlin Hayes to prevent another shot on goal, but it will be another set piece opportunity for Palace to try and double their lead here just inside the opening 10 minutes. The sides have already played here in the Women's Championship as well. That one finished 1-1. Lewis dominated, took the lead early. Palace fought back, and Lewis were made to regret missed chances. Short corner here for Palace. Lewis press well to clear the danger. Advantage played here. Chance for Zoe Ness to show her pace. Not much support, although Emma Jones was trying to push forwards through the centre.
Your bell man in the floor! Beep, beep.
Well turned by Ellie Noble, trying down the left hand side to free Emma Jones. Crouching tackle by Amy Taylor, and she does get the ball away to Jones, who is in here. Chooses to go alone, can't quite find the bottom right hand corner. You can certainly understand why she chose to take the shot. Perhaps a bit less pace and a cross might have played in the onrushing Lewis cavalry, particularly Emily Donovan. But a well-worked move by Lewis, and their best opportunity thus far of the game. With 11 minutes gone, if you have just joined us, whether you're watching online across the UK or via that viewing party that we are staging in New York, Lewis are trailing by an early goal scored by Magda Masengo. Masengo this time though is dispossessed. Again, more great strength from Emma Jones. Palace though on the counter. Cheryl Cassell unable to latch onto the through ball. Cassell has really peaked in women's football at this level. Now 28, former Irish international. Showed signs of what she could do during a 2-year spell with Lewis between 2014 and 2016. Important touch there by Annabelle Johnson of Crystal Palace to once again stop the danger woman at the moment. Emma Jones getting through, but she does manage to fire the ball in, and Ness will take the shot, and she'll equalise! And Lewis bounced straight back through Zoe Ness. She scored against Coventry, a late winner last time out in the Women's Championship, and on target with a neat finish on this occasion, firing the ball past Emma Gibbon. And Ness makes it 1-1, two early goals, 13 minutes gone, Lewis 1, Crystal Palace 1. Gos certainly got the drums going and brought the crowd back into this one. Twitter will be slightly ahead by 30 seconds to 1 minute, so we don't want to give away too many spoilers, but if you are using social media and have the stream on, you might learn about the goal before even I do, or at least it will appear that way. I promise you, I am here, and we are live. Johnson for Palace, dispossessed by Ness. There's suddenly confidence about Lewis. That was a nice idea, dinked in neatly, but just a little bit too firm for Emma Jones. Ness from Scotland and Jones from Wales, though, are combining well down this near left-hand side. Palace just looking a little bit rattled suddenly. Baptiste, though, does well to flip that ball forwards. Goddard now, the captain for Palace, into Massengo. She's got too much space. Went for the near post and stopped by Izzy Costa. Sengo didn't hit that as well as she would have liked. And you would expect Foster to make that stop at her near post. And it stays at 1-1 after 15 minutes. Another long ball over the top, and Lewis might have beaten the offside trap here. Jones being forced wide, and she almost snuffed it in at the far corner. Lewis half-heartedly appealing for a corner, but it will be a goal kick to Palace. Sengo once again, that's a neat ball. Here's Baptiste, it was a super ball. Bit lovely pressure and anticipation from Izzy Costa to flop her line and narrow the angle. And Baptiste has to settle for a corner. End to end though, at the moment it's an entertaining cup encounter in the early stages as we approach the 20 minute mark. To get the ball away. Baptiste will trot over to that far side to take this throw-in. The Dripping Pen, if you haven't been down, one of the most unique grounds in English football and arguably the best named as well. Vegan pies are all the rage here at half-time. They do beef and chicken though as well. Hopefully I'll be sampling that at half-time. Is a permanent fixture as well, as are the Earthquake drummers. Annie Timoney with the throw-in. Sengo goes backwards. Wolves have a chance here after that slightly overhead pass to force Palace back, and Johnson does go back to keeper Emma Gibbon. We'll try as well throughout this broadcast, depending on availability, and have a few special guests to break away from the blow-by-blow commentary and get a bit of insight into Lewis FC, including hopefully general manager of the women's team, Maggie Murphy. General manager of Lewis FC Women. She joins me now. Maggie, good afternoon. Very well. 1-1 between Lewis FC and Crystal Palace. Of course, we will break away from the chat if there is meaningful action and continue the commentary as well. But it's been a lively start, and I thought Lewis bounced back very well after conceding so early.
Yeah, we've been doing that well. We came 1-0 down just last week. So we
Zoe Ness has been someone that's impressed since joining Lewis, Scotland International, and somebody that since you joined the club you've been keeping a close eye on, and we're obviously delighted to get her to sign for Lewis. Tell me about what she brings to the setup here at the Dripping Pan.
Yeah, Zoe's fantastic. She's obviously got more than she has done.
So Palace have a throw in here on the right hand side, which Johnson will take. I was saying earlier on the stream, we're not just going around the world in terms of digital streaming of this game, but in particular there's a special viewing taking place in New York. Tell me a little bit about how that came about. Emotional afternoon ahead, her last game in professional football and thus as captain of Lewis as well. Is Emily Donovan dispossessed, and no whistle either, so Crystal Palace can come away with it up towards Cheryl Castle, the former Lewis attacking midfielder. And now on the right hand side we've got Annabelle Johnson in field towards Bianca Baptiste, who's been Palace's best player so far. That's excellent pressure though by Donovan, unfortunately unable to get the ball though on that occasion. It's back with Baptiste for Crystal Palace. There's an overlap on the right hand side with Annabelle Johnson. Instead it goes back to the tall centre back Amy Goddard, the former Yeovil centre back. Crystal Palace being ever pressed back. Lewis holding a pretty high line in this 4-2-3-1 formation. Emily Donovan able to support Zoe Ness as thus far. Emma Jones as well, but on the counter attack, here comes Annabelle Johnson for Palace. It's into a really dangerous area, and Crystal Palace will find themselves 2-1 up. And after all of that Lewis pressure, they've been haunted by a former player, Cheryl Castle, who scored 4 goals for Lewis between 2014 and 2016, has made it 2-1 to the visitors. The Irish international restores Palace's lead, and that's really disappointing, Maggie, obviously from a Lewis perspective because you're behind again, but also because since the goal it looked like Lewis was starting to take control of the game.
This challenge, I guess, is the beginning of the season where we control games, we are very strong in possession, stats are huge in that respect. So we often control, and then maybe our final ball lets us down. That's something we need to work on, because it's not enough to be holding possession the whole time, but we need to start converting. We've got plenty of people that can convert, it's just that last ball we really need to get right.
23 minutes gone, Lewis 1, Crystal Palace 2 here in the Conti Cup at the Dripping Field. In fairness to Palace, from their perspective, it was a Woolworth goal down the right-hand side, much like the first one. Annabelle Johnson able to break down the right, and they were both very strong deliveries into dangerous areas that, unfortunately, from Lewis's perspective, were well finished. drums continue and the atmosphere hasn't been altered, has it? When you go behind in games, many stadiums, particularly in professional football, there can sort of be a hush to the stadium. But what's nice about the experience here at the Dripping Pan is because it's a community-owned club, regardless of the score, the fans always feel a part of the atmosphere. And we'll come back to that in a moment as the ball's whipped in and Johnson, who got the assist for the Palace goal, is able to get it away with Emma Jones behind her. But I guess my point is that there's not many stadiums where you'd concede and suddenly the band and the drums would start to give the side on the field a bit of a boost.
It becomes easier to be positive when that's the case. But we're very proud, I guess, to be this community club, and you know, people are coming along. I know there's a bunch of people in here that have already played games this morning with the Red and Black of Lewis. They've done their games and they've come along. The noisy bunch with the band at the moment, they have a game at 4:30 p.m. kick-off time. So they're in here supporting Lewis before they go off and play their own games. It's a proper community that's getting behind it.
O'Rourke with the throw-in on this near left-hand side and then receives the ball back. Infield now to Ellie Noble. Lewis's centre-backs at the moment, Caitlin Hayes, but Macca as well, able to get right up to the halfway line, and that's a nice idea out on that right-hand side. A little bit too firm, though, on this occasion for Emily Donovan, who has been everywhere on the field, but at the moment has filtered over to that far right-hand side. But we have seen her be quite effective through the centre and even the occasional flurry onto the left as well. So there's quite a fluidity to the Lewis front line and even the wing-backs as well, Maggie. A lot of players very versatile, capable of switching sides and causing Crystal Palace problems this afternoon.
Yeah, that's one of Fran Alonso, our manager's tactics, is actually switch people about, and they found themselves playing positions they didn't think they ever would play. So Fran has a tendency to find specific elements of the player's game.
Here come Lewis once again, and that's half a shout for a free kick there, but Crystal Palace will come away with it. Too strong though on that occasion. And I was saying about Fran Alonso, Maggie, teaching players kind of extra strings to their bow and utilising their versatility, whether it's because they're strong on both feet or they're just better switching sides because it allows them to cut in field. What kind of impact do you think he's had since joining this club?
Yeah, definitely. So Fran joined at the beginning of this year. I guess this season is now where he made a lot of changes in the summer, brought in some new players. He's very keen on the possession style football. So, you know, his Spanish roots, maybe a bit of tiki-taka football that he's looking for. That's why we've got the strong possession stats.
Zoe Ness, the goal scorer for Lewis, almost the perfect ball through to Emma Jones. Again, it's well intercepted by Palace. A vital touch by Goddard in particular. And here come the visitors over the halfway line now. We haven't seen too much of Georgiou, but she's been very effective just holding that midfield in a disciplined way, allowing Ashley Goddard to get forwards a bit more. And those passes from Goddard have often created half chances or goals inadvertently, freeing up players on the right-hand side. Goddard ended up getting the assist for the first one herself, the Palace captain, and then freeing down that right-hand side for the second one, Annabelle Johnson, whose delivery led to Cheryl Castle's goal. That's given Crystal Palace a 2-1 lead after 27 minutes here at the Dripping Pan. Palace, of course, in the white, if you are unfamiliar with these two teams, and Lewis in their traditional red and black. Maggie, we'd be remiss if we don't break away from the action. Of course, like I say, we will interrupt any conversation to bring you any pertinent moments and tell you what's happening. And you can, of course, see it on the feed as well, as here comes Emma Jones down the left-hand side again. It's well defended by the excellent Annabelle Johnson, who's done well at both ends. So we'll bring in this corner, but then we have to talk about Macca because, of course, it is her last game for Lewis FC. And also, before I allow you to go, I want to discuss the pies as well. So those watching are jealous of some of the grub here at the Dripping Pan. But it is a corner to Lewis first, and an opportunity to draw level. Playing only with the single ball system means that there's often a delay when that ball gets stuck in the marshes of the grass on that far right hand side. But it has now found its way over to Ellie Noble, who will take this corner on the near left hand side. Plenty forwards for Lewis, including Donovan making a nuisance of herself in front of Emma Gibson. Wouldn't it be fitting if Macca can get on the score sheet here? Not the best delivery in truth to the near post. It's away by Palace, but they're very deep. A lot of opportunity for a counter-attack here, though. And a chance for Georgiou to free up the captain, Goddard, on his left-hand side. Baptiste did really well to start that because she was the only white shirt forwards, and now they're storming forwards for Crystal Palace. It's another dangerous ball, and that could have ended badly. Almost an own goal. Sophia Root gets away with one, and she actually did really well because had she not touched the ball, there was a player behind her, so she had to try and get something on it. It almost ended in an own goal, but luckily from Lewis's perspective, it's just a corner.
Yeah, Sophie will be really happy with that one. It looked a little bit close, especially from our angle. She did really well. Yeah, there was nothing else for it. Otherwise, she had another player on her right-hand shoulder.
Baptiste then with the corner. Sengo making a nuisance of herself. That goes straight out of play, though, marvellously. Lewis can breathe a sigh of relief. Half an hour gone, Lewis 1, Crystal Palace 2. And half an hour, so a third of the way through. Macca's last game for Lewis, Maggie. What kind of a player has she been for this club over an astonishing tenure since assuming the captaincy from Kelly Newton?
Yeah, even when I'm watching now, I'm just thinking, you know, it's going to be very, very different to not have Mac at the back. She's very visible, very present. She talks well on the pitch, proper leader out there, and very calm. I look at her sometimes and see how calm she is on the ball and how nothing seems to faze her. That's so important, I guess, from a captain. Mac has been around for many years. I think it's eight, nine seasons, I think. So, you'll see that she's a fan favourite. People have a lot of time for her. There's been a huge number of tributes coming through on social media, online. There's a beautiful piece written by Ash Head, a long-time fan of the club.
Three ball here, but offside against Donovan. So, Maggie, please continue.
Yeah, it's a beautiful tribute on our programme that you can find online. All our programmes are online. Beautiful tribute that really tracks her growth, I guess. I mean, when she joined Lewis here in her first season, she won the double. And that was under Jackie Agnew, who was the manager at the time, with Kelly Newton, who's another club hero. Interestingly, Kelly Newton has gone into a management position. She is managing the under-18s, who are also playing right now, just on the field behind us. And so we're also looking to see, you know, whether Macca wants to stay with the club and join the club in another capacity going forward.
More Macca in a moment, but here come Lewis again down the left-hand side, where they've had a fair amount of joy. And Amy Taylor, on her debut, almost finds Donovan. Orwin making a slight mess of that was Amy Goddard. No communication with her goalkeeper, Gibson, but Palace able to avoid an embarrassing own goal. And in the end, Gibson did pretty well just to get her feet on the ball. And now the goal scorer and the difference between the sides, Castle. She's unable to find Zhou Zhao. Gibbon, much like Foster, both young goalkeepers getting a rare opportunity in the Conte Cup to show what they're capable of. Both have made some solid saves so far. That looks a little bit too strong for Lesengo, and calmly as ever, Macca able to put the ball out of play. You may not know the answer even to this, Maggie, but it's sort of atypical, I guess, to start a football season, then retire. Have you had any sense as to why Macca's made the decision now as opposed to in the off-season or the end of the season?
I think for her, it's been a very difficult decision for her. I think that it's been something that she's chewed over for a long time and has chewed over in the past as well, not just this season or the last few weeks, but, you know, it's been a long, hard decision, and probably she's just decided that maybe this is the time.
32 minutes gone. Lewis 1, Crystal Palace 2. A warm welcome to you wherever you are watching. Don't forget to interact with us on social media as well. And if you are in that bar in particular in New York, do make sure that you take lots of photos. We'd love to see them on social media as well. Perhaps you're up early for that West Ham-Liverpool game in New York in particular. Send a photo of the stream so we can see what that viewing party is like, and make sure you tweet us as well. We've certainly been treated to a lot of early action, but unfortunately Lewis are trailing by 2-1. The Conte Cup more broadly, Maggie, though, is relatively interesting because it gives Lewis the opportunity to play some of the big guns in the WSL, and I suppose in particular Lewis are most looking forward in terms of marketing the club and showing this experience at the Dripping Pan, regardless of the result, to welcoming Emma Hayes as Chelsea.
We're very excited about that. November 2nd, which is a Saturday, so traditionally in our league, most games are played on the Sunday. We're really keen to show off the club, to get a... We're very keen for our pathway teams, all our elite teams, but also all the way down to the girls and boys teams to come in.
Long ball forwards looking for Castle, a little bit too strong, not room for her aerial prowess, and that's safely out of play for a goal kick.
So we're hoping that that game against Chelsea on November 2nd we'll see a really big turnout. We're really proud of our club. We're keen for the teams to come down. We'd love to see Emma Hayes here and various England and Scotland players as well coming down. It'll be fantastic to see someone like Frank Kirby in the middle of the field here.
We'll go on the right-hand side. And here's Emily Donovan streaming into the centre as Jones. It's back towards Timoney and now Noble. She takes a hot shot, but the ball was a bit too close to that right foot, and sadly, it's skies well out and over the bar to the right-hand side. So it's a goal kick to Crystal Palace, and with 10 minutes or so until the break, it's Lewis 1, Crystal Palace 2. I see a few people as well, Maggie, just in front of me eating what I think are Magnum ice creams, white chocolate Magnum ice creams. And it's funny because we thought it would tip it down with rain, but in an odd way, everything's settled down now, and although it's a bit breezy, it's kind of perfect conditions for football, and it probably is warm enough in a strange sense, if the wind dies down anyway, for an ice cream.
It's pretty muggy out here. It's a bit of a muggy, strange afternoon. We were expecting a lot of rain. We haven't seen it. It's actually really quite perfect for playing football. Let's see what happens in the second half, though.
Mum's got a cup of coffee here, I can see, so it's a mixture between hot and cold, I guess. I mentioned earlier those pies. For those maybe, I guess, around the area, maybe you're watching in London, you've heard that Chelsea game, you realise suddenly that Lewis is only about an hour and 15 minutes from London Victoria Station, so very accessible and very close to the station as well. And all I've been banging on about, other than the drummers, are these pies, because they are famous down here at the Dripping Pan. What are they? I mean, they're pies, obviously, but what kind of pies, and why are they so popular?
I mean, it's funny, because we are very...
just a moment, but free kick here in a dangerous position to Crystal Palace, and I think the referee just briefly did think Alex Bradley about a card, but it looks like we'll have a pause in play and an injury break, and then Crystal Palace will take this free kick, so that does give us the opportunity to talk about pies again.
Well, yeah, so we are very proud of the pies. We have the usual. We've got a really good steak pie, mash, mushy peas, gravy, the whole full lot. But the vegan pies are the ones that people, they seem to fly off the shelves, and people are kind of, find themselves massive fans of our vegan, I think it's Tuscan bean pies. People love them, so that's one thing that we tell people, don't eat your lunch, come and get it down here. So
they look like they come in mushy peas.
They are delicious. I don't even like mushy peas, but they're good.
Second half, we're just going to hear them chomping on the pie. There'll be very little commentary coming, but the first half, at least, we've got proper commentary. And Lewis will be available throughout the season as well. I believe the next stream that you can hear Lewis will be your allocated ones on this new FA Match Player, and some of the Championship games will be available on that. It's only a couple of times a season, and you've already had one, haven't you, that's been streamed. So there is the opportunity periodically, albeit sporadically, to watch Lewis online through the FA Match Player, and a few times a season you'll be able to do this as well.
Yeah, we're hoping to stream online October the 13th, our home game against Leicester City. That's going to be a really great game. We're really looking forward to the visitors. It's part of our dedication to wanting to help our fans from around the world be able to see it online. We'd love it if we were able to stream a few more, but otherwise we have to wait to see what our allocation is on the new FA Player, which is a fantastic app for people to download. They can get all their content from the WSL and one game a week from our league, the Championship. We've got so Leicester City is going to be definitely streamed online, and we're looking to choose one of our next games as well. So if you have a particular interest in a particular game and you can't get here, then let us know on social media and we'll have a think about that.
Palace's free kick, and Maka couldn't quite get there, but Caitlin Hayes mops up with her head. Andrea Georgiou, the ex-London Bees midfielder, was the player down, and she's come on, still walking a little gingerly, but certainly in no danger of being sucked. And then the long ball forwards for Amy Taylor. a little bit too strong. Maybe Taylor incidentally is a member of the Lewis Book Club, but I think what's great, Maggie, about a community-owned club is that these players are seen around town, they're integrated within the community, some are known at local haunts, lots of them have got favourite places around town, some are members, like I just mentioned, Amy Taylor of the Book Club as well, so there seems like there's a real engagement between players and fans.
Yeah, the funny thing about the Book Club is that I think that's within the players. We suddenly heard that there was a little group of them that were getting together and actually having their own chats about various thrillers. I think there's thrillers that they've gone for. But no, there's a good vibe amongst the squad. They're they're very embedded. So interestingly enough, the higher that Lewis goes in the leagues, the more international our players are and national, but the more likely they are to live in Lewis because they've moved to the club to be here. So that's when we get the likes of Zoe Ness on the ball at the moment, who's moved down from Durham all the way in and now is living in the town. We see even Annie at the right back there. She's moved into the town but also works in a cafe in town, so people will pop in and ask her how she is, how the results are going. Very much more present in the community, which is a great thing for the fans as well.
Hayes to fire this free kick forwards. 5 minutes to go until half time. Launched in towards Donovan. Couldn't quite get ahead to it. There's Macca, dispossessed by Annabelle Johnson. And Palace again come down the right hand side where they've been a big threat in the first half. Haven't done too much down the left. Goddard on the ball now. Former England under 17 international. Lofted out to the right hand side. Annabelle Johnson should be able to keep this ball in. Boxed in the corner though. Lewis able to take shape and get plenty back in the box, and that's well defended by Sophie O'Rourke. He's just keeping Donovan honest and keeping Johnson in the corner. There's a throw into Palace, up towards Masengo, and now drilled into the box again. Castle, the goal scorer. Three around her, works it out well to Johnson. That's blocked by Emma Jones, the Welsh striker, being forced to defend in the corner. And Lewis just pushed deep, and Crystal Palace continued to exert pressure. We'll wrap up with Maggie just before half time as well, because she, of course, will have responsibilities. So, Maggie, just some final thoughts. I guess the key at this stage, from the match's point of view, is just to, at worst, get in at half time 2-1 and not cave under this pressure in the last few minutes from Crystal Palace.
Yeah, definitely. Like I've said, we've shown great resilience in the past. We've come back already once or twice a season, so it's not impossible. We've got excellent skill on the field, but also on the bench, so if we need to shake things up, we can. And ultimately, it's a great chance to get a new set of players out on this pitch at the moment, a few of them with their first starts for the club as well. I'm sure we'll come back strong.
Great stuff. Maggie, thank you for your time. We might speak to you again before the end of the game. That's Maggie Murphy, the general manager of Lewis FC Women. So Crystal Palace leading Lewis by 2-1. Here's Baptiste down the right-hand side for Palace once again. She's had a strong first half. That's a dangerous ball into the box. It's half cleared into the path of O'Rourke. O'Rourke has done well. She's been the defender under the most pressure, although unfortunately both goals have come down that right hand side, but not much that she could do about either, because they were menacing deliveries into the box and well converted. The opening goal by Masenga and the second one by Cassell, and that hurts because she's a former Lewis player. A little bit too strong on that occasion, but in muggy conditions the ball will take a hard bounce, and Baptiste able to keep the ball in play again. O'Rourke does well to police her though, and Lewis well aware of the threat down this right hand side, are pressing and making sure no easy crosses can come in, and they've forced Crystal Palace back here, all the way back in fact, and now Zoe Ness can exert a bit of pressure from the front, and it's back with Gibbon, and Lewis can take their shape. 2 minutes to go until half time. Lewis 1, Crystal Palace 2. Conte Cup action here at the Dripping Pan. A very good afternoon to you wherever you are watching the stream. Baptiste has a bit of space on the right hand side, but she can't quite keep that in. Fortunate bounce that just zipped off the surface and safely out for a goal kick. Just 90 seconds or so to go, plus added time, of which there'll be about a minute, no doubt, before the break. Lewis looked like trailing at the break in Macca's final game as a professional footballer. Attacking midfielder almost making it 3-1 to Crystal Palace, but an athletic save from Foster. It was at a good height for her, but she had to make up a bit of ground to her left and palms the ball out for a corner kick. Really important from Lewis's perspective, they don't concede right on the stroke of half time. Palace looking to exploit what might be the last chance of the half. Nicole Pepper, the ex Chelsea defender or midfielder, takes it, and Foster surely fouled there as she was about to collect the ball, as she takes a blow to the right hand side of the head. Gets up a little slowly, but she should be okay as well. She can also get that looked at half time, during half time as well. We will be speaking to Charlie Dobray, one of the directors here at Lewis FC. As well, so he'll be doing most of the talking. Heading into added time here, another opportunity for Baptiste, but quickly off her line is Izzy Foster, who's recovered well after taking that knock from the corner. And that should just about do it for the opening half, unless Lewis can muster one final chance. That's neatly worked by Aroub to Amy Taylor, but offside. Official on the far side had a good look at that and was quick to raise his flag. Emma Gibbon taking her time here, the 20-year-old. No surprise there. Referee looks at his watch, and that is half time. And Lewis are trailing Crystal Palace here in the Conti Cup by 2-1. Michael Maseko scored the opening goal for Palace. Zoe Ness, Scottish international, cancelled it out for Lewis. But Cheryl Castle, the former Lewis player, is the difference between the sides of the break. Lewis have looked lively and bright. Crystal Palace have been clinical at the other end. Join us again across the world for live commentary of the second half of the Conti Cup between Lewis and Crystal Palace in 15 minutes' time. Or stay with us over half time. And once the drumming dies down, we will be doing some interviews as well with Charlie Dobray, the director here at Lewis FC. So thanks for joining us. Half time score and the dripping pan in the Conti Cup. Lewis 1, Crystal Palace 2.
just announcements. So the raffle tickets, if you have your raffle tickets ready, we have the winning four tickets are blue 650, blue 647, pink 920, and pink 915. Just to read those again. The winning raffle ticket numbers are blue 650, blue 647, pink 920, and pink 915. Prizes are available at the Rookin Bar. Thank you.
Regulations, but something that we'll be pushing over the next few weeks.
equal pay US women's national team. And if you know anyone who plays the team or works around the team, let them know that they fully have our support. Thank you.
So, half-time, Lewis trailing Crystal Palace by 2 goals to 1. Ben Jacobs, as you just heard a moment ago, Charlie Dobre, director here at Lewis FC, is joining me. You also might see a dog enter the shot. Lewis FC is dog-friendly, and I, of all people, have chosen to bring my own dog, Winnie, alongside me.
Hi, Winnie.
I go on camera, she does too. You might see her jumping up and disrupting things, or if we pan down, you'll be able to see she's already tried to steal the attention away from Charlie. But, Charlie, let's have a little chat about the game, first of all, and
yes,
more broadly, and we'll continue some commentary as well into the second half as well. But unfortunately, the scoreline not going Lewis's way at the moment. Crystal Palace have looked dangerous down the right-hand side, but plenty of positives as well from Lewis in the first 45.
I think it's quite an open game, maybe unusually from when we played the league match a few weeks ago. Both sides have rotated their squads, which is absolutely right. It's a long season, so I think we can be broadly happy with it. Obviously, you don't want to be 2-1 down, but I think there are signs that our strike force are lively today, and we do have an extremely good strike force as well, so I'm optimistic for the second half.
Of course, regardless of the game, this is going to be a very special afternoon for Mika and everybody affiliated with Lewis FC in the last game as a professional footballer, and thus surrendering the captaincy at the same time. Just tell me a little bit about what she means to Lewis FC.
There aren't really the words. I mean, Mac has been here for 9 seasons. You know, people use the word iconic and legend and throw it about in football, but Katie really is. She's an absolute model professional. She is utterly committed on the pitch. I think that if you don't see a few more crunching tackles today from Katie, I'll be really, really surprised. I think you can lead by what you say, and she does that, but I think most importantly, you lead by example. And Macca's example is a superb one for young players and for all players. And the fact that she's dedicated 9 years of her career to us, we're just really privileged and grateful.
Of course, it's early stages, and she'll have her own views about what she wants to do next. But from Lewis's point of view, it would be very fun and interesting to keep her in the club in some capacity, whether that's coaching or ambassadorial. And no doubt you and the rest of the directors are in favour of that.
Yeah, I think when a great player, any player, comes to end their career, it's a really tough decision for them about when to do it and how to do it. And I think that all doors are open. So Kelly Newton, an absolute club legend, she stepped down and retired a little while back, and she's now gone on to be coaching in our youth setup, and we absolutely love that. So we love it when players, as they kind of retire, still want to be at the club. We still want them to be at the club, but I think at the moment, you know, Mac will want to think about her options, but certainly all doors are open.
Just finally for now, we'll pick it up in the second half as well, we'll chat a little bit more. The Conte Cup is very important. Lewis are unbeaten in the league, and the priority will be to try and get promotion or somewhere close under Fran Alonso. But this is also an opportunity away from Crystal Palace to see what life might be like in the top division with the likes of Spurs, who got promoted last season, and also in particular Chelsea coming down to the dripping pan here. And in games like that, I think that's November the 2nd, will be fantastic occasions.
Yeah, I mean, the Conte Cup is an opportunity for clubs in the Championship, because it's just for the top two leagues, to play some of the big teams in the league above. And we had the opportunity last year, and this year against Chelsea. I think it'll be a great test. I mean, we don't know exactly what team they'll bring, but I think, you know, you're a football player, you're a football manager, you're a football director. You want to win every game. However, I think that, you know, this is... it's a competition which... All competitions are important, but I think, although it's a cliche to say, the main thing is the league. I think it's fair to say that. And then, of course, with the FA Cup, we'll be entering the FA Cup at the fourth round stage. We don't yet know who we're playing, and that's another really important competition. So there are a lot of competitions to be in, and I think that I can see your dog is equally excited about those competitions as well. So I think, listen, we are going to win today. I feel optimistic, but there's a number of games in this competition. Let's see what happens.
Just alerting me to the fact the second half about to get on the way, and the drumming has started as well. Charlie, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
And we'll talk more during the second half. So half time, and Lewis are trailing by 2-1, and we'll have full commentary coming next. So welcome back to the Dripping Pan, second half about to get underway. Ben Jacobs with you for commentary of the Conte Cup opening fixture between Lewis and Crystal Palace, the host trailing by 2-1. Magda Masengo with the opening goal for the visitors, cancelled out by Zoe Ness, and Cheryl Castle is currently the difference between the two sides. One change at halftime, Ethan Roth Botham has gone off and Danny Lane has replaced her. It's a 4-2-3-1 for Lewis. And for Crystal Palace, they're playing in a 4-4-2. And it doesn't appear that the visitors have made any changes thus far. We were talking at halftime to Charlie Dobre, one of the directors here at Lewis FC, and we'll grab a word with him in just a moment as the second half gets underway. Danny Lane, a more attacking option to either Rothbottom, who has gone off. The drums will continue throughout the second half as well. They are the Earthquake Drummers, and will certainly add to the atmosphere here at Lewis FC. The attendance should be somewhere around the 250 mark as Donovan loops the ball in. Couldn't on that occasion find a teammate though. So Lewis with Izzy Foster in goal, who made a vital late save to deny Crystal Palace, and their captain in particular, Ashley Goddard, a third. Timony, Caitlin Hughes, Sophie O'Rourke, and Amy Taylor, as well as Katie McIntyre in her last game. We were talking about that at half time before retiring. Ellie Noble, substitute Danny Lane, Emma Jones, Emily Donovan, and Zoe Ness. We'll see whether or not Fran Alonso changes things up a bit so as to play two up top and give Ness a bit more support. I'm sure that will be the case as this game continues if the score remains 2-1 to Palace. Crystal Palace 4-4-2, Emma Gibbon in goal, Annabelle Johnson, Hannah McKenzie, Amy Goddard, Nicole Pepper, Bianca Baptiste, who was lively in the first half, Andrea Georgiou, who did pick up an injury but appears to have shaken that off and is now moving fine, Ashley Goddard and Aoife Hurley, haven't seen too much of the former Villa player, and Cheryl Castle and Magda Masengo up top, both of whom have goals. Sun's gone in now, breeze has picked up, might get a little bit of rain over the course of the second half. Relatively muggy conditions, although overall not quite the swimming pool conditions we might have expected, given when you woke up this morning it was supposedly a high of about 15 degrees and light showers throughout the day. Jones worked him well. Oh, and a golden opportunity for Ness. She sort of just toe-poked it with her weaker left foot and couldn't hit the target. She tried to take goalkeeper Emma Gibbon by surprise. By the way, I had a pie at half-time, and it was magnificent. And it's not just a pie either. It was undersold. It's a pie with beef, downed in gravy, offside here against Cheryl Castle. Luckily, because I was in the midst of a pie rant. It's a pie with gravy and beef, and then mashed potato, and then mushy peas. And even though each of those facets are separate, when blended all together, the taste erupts in the mouth, and it's one of the best half-time snacks that I've ever had. And I like to think the Lewis players have won at half-time as well, and that will be the difference in this game as they look to get back in it. Palace, though, do look dangerous on the counter-attack, and this is a golden opportunity, and almost from Baptiste as she lifted the ball over the goalkeeper. Couldn't quite hit the target. It was an intuitive finish from distance, and Foster did well to sprint off her line and at least put a bit of pressure onto Baptiste, who realised that the keeper was off her line. But that extra few yards of acceleration from Foster at least stopped it being a simple dinked finish, and instead gave Baptiste more to think about. She acted it earlier as a result, and just slightly overcooked it. Certainly not a bad effort. Lewis survive. Crystal Palace, though, are looking very dangerous on the counter-attack. We'll bring in Charlie Dobre to the feed in about 5 minutes as well. He's a busy man on camera, on tannoy, and on commentary. Really needs three of him, if possible. Married, of course, to Karen Dobre, another familiar figure here at Lewis FC. Both of them fighting the football and gender equality cause at the same time. And he mentioned at half-time that Lewis FC paying their men and women the same, but also supporting the US Women's National Team campaign to gain equal pay. The case strengthened after their tremendous victory at the Women's World Cup. Or perhaps as a Brit, I should say, their slightly fortuitous victory at the Women's World Cup. They were brilliant throughout the tournament, on the best side, of course, but it was a tight semi-final game against England, and from a personal point of view, three guesses which team I was supporting in that match. VAR saved the Americans from possible extra time. The balance, though, they were wonderful and fully deserving of their trophy. I say that also because we've got a lot of US fans no doubt watching. We are putting on a special screening for this game in New York. And if you are at that viewing party, make sure on social media you stick up a photo or two so we can see how you're getting on. 50 minutes gone. And Lewis may well think about another substitution in just a moment, especially if in the next 5 or 10 minutes they can't get a breakthrough. Alonso in front of me, looking pensive. Crystal Palace very much could use a win. They've started the season with 2 draws and 2 losses, and they were hammered last time out, losing 6-0 at home to Aston Villa. Villa are going to be one of the favourites to win the Women's Championship. By no means unbeatable, though, I thought in the opening game of the season, even though they looked very lively on the attack, London Bees were unlucky to lose that game by 3-2. Jones and Noble standing over the ball, and it will be Noble to deliver. Takes a little hesitation. In fact, went for a sort of surprise drilled shot, which looked intentional to me. and it's punched away by Emma Gibbon. Lewis now will have a corner. Talking about gender equality, we see during some of these set pieces on the near right hand side and also in the centre of the field, if the ball goes out on the far left, banners that say Equality FC. Equality has become a big part of the personality of this football club, as here's Ness with a free header, and of all people it's Masengo, the striker, who gets to the near post and nudges the ball away just when it looked like Lewis might score a headed equaliser. But the pressure continues to mount now with a free kick and back-to-back corners. Crystal Palace though staying strong at the moment. Ellie Noble with the corner once again. Both hands up in the air and in it comes. Again into a dangerous area. Gibbon felt she was fouled and the late whistle confirms it's a free kick to Crystal Palace. And even though it was the keeper that won that free kick, as she went to palm the ball away, there's two other Palace defenders down. And it does look like we've got a head injury here. Let's just bring in Charlie Dobre whilst we've got a break in play. Like I say, he's a busy man because he has to do commentary, tannoy, oversee various things as a director.
Dog keeping.
On camera as well. He's dog sitting as well for me.
Dog sitting. He's a great dog though.
Charlie, thanks for joining me once again. It's been a bright start to the second half by Lewis. A few half chances, a lot of pressure. So I'd imagine that Fran Alonso will be relatively happy with the opening 10 minutes. It's just a case of actually putting a finish to this pressure.
I think that's right. I think we seem to be in the final third a lot more even than the first half. And I think that's it's a positive thing. Still a very open game though.
Over on the left-hand side is Emma Jones. We'll talk about the club's support of the US Women's National Team, which Charlie mentioned at half-time in just a moment as well, when we get a break in play. Crystal Palace, though, very deep. They're still in the 4-4-2, but their two central midfielders are almost like holding defensive midfielders now, and they've not really got any outlets. And as long as Masengo ends up, as she was a moment ago, chasing down that left-hand side, she can't cause too much danger. She's strong and physical, but certainly the Lewis back line will be able to defend against pace with long balls that she's chasing. Castle, on the other hand, has plenty of acceleration. On the ball at the moment to Zhou Zhao, who wasn't really sure what she was doing on that occasion and ended up just looping it over the top of the bar. I think she was trying to dink the ball forwards to the onrushing Ashley Goddard, but just overcooked it slightly, and it is a goal kick to Lewis. As the drums continue to pound and the band plays and the atmosphere by no means being affected by the scoreline at the moment. That's a bit too strong and asking too much of Zoe Ness. And again, Palace's defensive midfielders will work it up to Goddard, the ex-Arsenal player. Castle has to hold her line. She's being well policed by Caitlin Hayes. And Macker will just let that ball go out of play. And as she does so, just by that advertising board that says Equality FC. Charlie, you were mentioning at half time about Lewis's natural support for the US Women's National Team and their campaign to get equal pay. Just tell me a little bit more about that as we see a block shot from Hayes in the corner to Crystal Palace.
Well, I think what we've identified is, I mean, we've been running our, well, it's now set policy for the last 2 years to give equal resources, playing budget, marketing, same pitch, same everything, of course, the women's and men's team. But I think what we notice is there's a number of struggles coming up around the world. So we have the US Women's National Team, we have the Reggae Girls, Jamaica's national team, who've gone on strike because they've literally been paid nothing, as far as I remember, since qualifying for the last World Cup. We've had the things going on. Obviously, Norway have achieved some pay parity as well. We had the disputes with the Irish national team a little while back. I think as you look around the world, what you see is an awful lot of disputes in the same area. And I think we want to help to be a catalyst to bring all that together. We really do. And I think it's also connected with increasing work we're doing with the United Nations Women Organization to generally, a bit of action here.
Here comes Pepe's corner, and Baptiste gets a toes to it, but Lewis able to clear, albeit there's no outlet. Sorry, Charlie, please.
No, absolutely. The football comes first. So there are a number of things going on around the world in women's football, women's sport, but women's football in particular. And I think that we would love to start pulling those things together, helping to pull them together, because maybe with that added weight, we can affect some genuine change. So, for example, one thing we absolutely want any government to copy from the United States is the Title IX law passed in 1972, which mandates any educational organisation receiving government money to have to spend it equally between men and women. And really, when people say what was the secret of success in the US soccer women's soccer team, you'd have to say it started 50 years ago when they started spending the same money in educational institutions. And we don't see why that can't have exactly the same thing in the UK.
Johnson couldn't keep the ball in play, so Lewis had a throw-in just inside their own half. Fran Alonso looks like he's considering another substitution imminently. I would imagine it will be Ella Powell if he is to introduce anybody, but we'll confirm that change as it happens, assuming of course it does. Noble battling hard. Georgiou, though, has been dogged and resolute in central midfield for Crystal Palace, and Hannah McKenzie as well has done strong on the sun work. Jones, though, for Lewis, has space on the right-hand side. Can't cut towards the byline. Timoney in support to our right-hand side. Again, though, it's really well defended by Palace, who have looked far more disciplined than in their 6-0 loss to Aston Villa last time out. Lewis will be hoping that they tire, though, over the course of the last half an hour or so, and then gaps appear. And in the second half, Lewis is certainly having more share of the ball. 51-49 across the first half, but in the opening 15 minutes of the second, Lewis have had 64% of the ball, so hopefully that possession from the home side's perspective will turn into some kind of penetration in the final third and ultimately a goal. And it is going to be Ella Powell coming on.
Substitution for Lewis, leaving the pitch number 20, Sophie O'Rourke, and Sophie joining O'Rourke. The pitch is number 11, Ella Powell.
Ella Powell will replace her. Crystal Palace are also thinking about their first change. A couple of substitutes are warming up, and we will bring you details of Dean Davenport's substitution again when it happens, which is likely to be imminently, and a defensive one as well. He may be forced into a change as well, because at the moment Masengo is down and clutching her right knee. Hopefully from the visitors' perspective that's nothing too serious, but it might just put a spanner in the works as far as Davenport and his tactics are concerned. So we'll have another break in play. A chance for Lewis just to get together, and by the looks of things, whilst Crystal Palace come off for a drinks break, Lewis are just having a communion on the far side. And this is maybe, Charlie, a last opportunity for Maka to sort of give a captain's talk.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen this so many times through the years. Spirit is incredible. People listen to what she says. She sees the game. So let's see what happens after this. I think sometimes a breaking play like this can actually be helpful to regroup. I think Lewis are pushing really well. It's just not quite making the clear-cut chances in the box.
Crystal Palace will be thinking, like I say, about a change. I think it will be Ria Ladat, who is the first player to come on for the visitors. A centre-back or defensive midfielder, depending on where she's utilised, that again is capable of either allowing Dean Davenport to go to a back three or a three-woman midfield. Asengo is okay, incidentally, so no cause for her to go off. Play continues, though, now at the moment, and we await that Palace substitution when there's a break in play.
Substitution
should be now
for Crystal Palace.
And it is indeed Ria Ladat who will enter the field.
And coming on is number 25, Ria Ladat, and leaving the pitch, number 11, Bianca Baptiste.
And it's a shame for Palace, because Bianca Baptiste is the player who's been forced off. I think she was carrying a knock as well, the former QPR, Spurs and Arsenal winger. and she has had a very good hour or so, Baptiste, and I think it's fair to say that Lewis will not be sad to see the back of Baptiste, who's looked lively down that right-hand side. But Ladat is on, much more defensive player. And the whistle in Lewis's favour here will stop any kind of threat to the goal of Izzy Foster, who's proven herself a capable understudy from the hour or so that we've seen so far. Lewis 1, Crystal Palace 2, wherever you are following the stream. Thanks for joining us. Ben Jacobs, and at the moment, Charlie Dobro, director at Lewis FC. Alongside me, Timoney. Palace 1 offside, but easily onside was Jones, and it's drilled into a really dangerous area. It may fall to the back post. It's unselfish, and a chance for the substitute there. It's really well saved, though, by Gibbon in the end. Golden opportunity for Danny Lane. Danger not over. Jones, another dangerous ball in. Once again, Danny Lane flicks it onto that back post, and there's Donovan. Lane once more pulls the trigger just over the bar. Three golden opportunities, Charlie, particularly the first and the last. One was saved, one whistled over the bar, but Danny Lane coming off the bench and making an impact.
Yeah, you have to give credit, I think, to the keeper for an original save there, but the ball just did not want to go in, but the pressure is mounting.
Still, though, 2-1 to Palace, but Lewis coming closer and closer. When the ball originally floated over to the far post, there was Donovan, and she possibly unselfishly chose to lay it back before it eventually fell to Lane. And had she shot herself, she might have had a simple finish at the near post, although it was a reasonably tight angle. Noble. Nice touch again by the excellent Jones, the Welsh striker, starting to boss the game on that right-hand side. Georgiou, though, composed, comes away with it, and now Goddard almost freeing Ladat. Instead, it goes to Casal, and now Masenga! Couldn't hit the target, though. Needed to go across the goal or cross the ball. Went for the near post from a difficult angle, and Foster had that hit the target. Probably had it covered anyway. Just a warning, though, to Lewis that Crystal Palace continue to be a threat down that right-hand side on the counter-attack. Ness, neat touch. Noble spreads it out to the left-hand side. It's a long old chase, though, for Donovan. And it's a Crystal Palace throw-in. 64 minutes gone here at the Dripping Pan. Don't forget to interact with us across social media as well. We'd love to hear from you, in particular if you're watching the game in New York up bright and early. Apparently, as I understand it, it's being streamed in a bar as well, where West Ham and Liverpool will come up against each other, and supporters clubs, official ones in New York from both of those clubs, are going down as well. So we expect a big attendance early morning in New York. Over brunch now, late breakfast, whichever way you want to look at it, but they'll be having their eggs, bacon and sausages, a cup of coffee and maybe something a bit stronger, and all the way across the pond watching Lewis FC women try and get back into this one. And you do sense there's more goals in this one, either because Lewis push forwards and get hit on the counter attack where Palace look dangerous, or just because there's so much pressure now from Lewis from set pieces, balls in particular down the right, that Palace may struggle to keep this fragile lead. That corner's a bit strong, but it will fall to Danny Lane. Ball didn't come down quick enough for her, though. Deep cross back in. The intended target was Caitlin Hayes, but again, just hit a little bit too firmly. And it's a goal kick. First half behind that Lewis goal, the drummers move, so they're always behind the goal that Lewis is shooting into, which again is the flexibility of a community-owned club where you can move around rather than having rigid seating. So first half you'd have seen that stand empty, second half the bands are behind the goal, trying to provide a soundtrack for this Lewis comeback, and that's drilled in at the near post, and looking a bit uneasy there was Emma Gibbon, but a fierce shot from Emma Jones only finds the side netting. Midway through the second half, Lewis 1, Crystal Palace 2 in the Conte Cup, with the likes of Spurs and Chelsea to come. Two groups in the Conte Cup. FA WSL champions Arsenal are in the other group. But Emma Hayes' Chelsea must come down here to the Dripping Pan. I'm sure they'll be in for a warm welcome. Asenga's looking tired now and she won't get to that. It's back with Foster. Under a bit of pressure though, Lewis choosing to pass their way out of danger here. By the way, if you're wondering why Charlie is quiet, he's got a pie now. A well-deserved break. It's not as good as my pie though. Mine came with full trappings like mushy peas and mashed potato, and this is just a standard plain pie. Lewis could be in here. Golden opportunity! And there's the equaliser! It is Amy Taylor! She scores on her debut! And Lewis deservedly draw level! She's a member of the Lewis Book Club, and that was textbook. Dinked over the top, waited for the keeper to make her move and go down, lifted it over into the middle of the goal on the left-hand side, and Amy Taylor has a debut goal. And the 27-year-old draws Lewis level. Lewis 2, Crystal Palace 2. Give Charlie a pie more often, because as soon as it got put in his hands and he started to take
it, it's the pie that won it.
They equalised.
It's the vegan pie that did it.
It's definitely the pie. And that will be a morale boosting goal for Amy Taylor, like I say, making her full debut for Lewis. First start. And she'll be absolutely delighted with that. Lewis now on course, with 20 minutes to go to protect their unbeaten run. Here and the band just playing a little bit louder. There's a spring in Lewis's step, and Crystal Palace need to decide now tactically whether they want to try and protect a point. Obviously, with so many games in the round robin, it's not essential to go for the win for either team. Back to Masengo from the captain Goddard. A little firm, asking quite a bit of Casal, and she won't keep the ball in play. Ella Powell shepherding her well. Lewis are thinking about the third and final substitution on the touchline in front of me. Fran Alonso will feel confident with 20 minutes remaining that his side can find a third. 1-1 when the sides met in the league. 2-2 at the moment in the Conte Cup. Great opportunity there, and it's a wonder goal. And again, Lewis have been hit immediately. This time it is the substitute with an absolutely sensational finish, Ria Ladat. And she scored an absolute worldie. And that has stunned Lewis. It's a brilliant finish into the top left-hand corner. Given the space outside the area, invited to shoot, and unfortunately from the home side's perspective, she's made Lewis pay, and Crystal Palace have the lead once again. And just as Lewis thought, they had a stranglehold on the game, much like at 1-1. Crystal Palace find a means of getting their noses ahead once again. Another substitution for Lewis, their final one, and it will be Katie Rood entering the fray. And she will replace Emma Jones. Football's such an unpredictable game, and each time Lewis have wrestled momentum back and looked the more likely to take the lead. Crystal Palace, who have never trailed, have found a means to score, and they're not really known as a goal scoring side. Palace thumped last time out 6-0 against the championship leaders Villa, and that was at home as well. But three goals this afternoon in an entertaining game. Sengo and Casal, the other scorers for Palace. Amy Taylor and Zoe Ness for Lewis FC. Pepper's throwing down the line. Ladap, the goal scorer, will try and play that off Timoney. And a flag is up, which will allow Lewis to reset. 18 minutes remain. Thanks, by the way, to Charlie Dobre, director at Lewis FC, who will go off and take a much-earned break. And with 17 minutes left, Fran Alonso has made his three changes. Root is his last throw of the dice in those bright orange boots. She doesn't win the ball on this occasion. Noble with her head. There's also 18 minutes remaining, plus injury time, of Katie McIntyre's career. She's retiring after this, and we expect a guard of honour to close, and we'll bring you that as well on the stream. Wonderful servant to this club, playing at centre back, has been a defensive midfielder as well, known for her dead ball delivery. Maybe, just maybe, Lewis will get a free kick within distance and she will choose to have a go. But at the moment, Crystal Palace will feel in control once again. Casal back towards Goddard. Now Georgiou, the anchor of this Palace team. Chance though on the counter attack now. Amy Taylor, the goal scorer. Ness and Root. Goes to Ness. Root was calling for it at the back post, and nobody was picking up Root. And the ball could have maybe gone long and diagonal. Still half an opportunity though for Lewis as they pick up the ball in midfield. Danny Lane, though, was let down by her second touch. The ball just didn't come down quick enough, and she sort of scuffed it a little bit, allowing Palace just to retain possession. And you can see that Masengo is in absolutely no hurry now. She's dropped right into central midfield and is really just looking to give her side a bit of respite here. Long ball forwards then for Palace, which is intercepted by Ella Powell. Crystal Palace, though, just happy to keep the ball at the moment, although a careless pass there will give Lewis another opportunity to come forwards here. There's again space with the substitute Root down the right-hand side, storming forward. She needs to get back, though, now, as Ladau, who's the difference between the two sides, will try and set Masinga away down the left-hand side. Clever defending, though, by the solid Caitlin Harris, but it will be a Crystal Palace throw, and they are in absolutely no hurry to take it. Trotting over is Pepper to take the throw in. She won't be peppering this one in though at all. She'll be going short and just trying to keep the ball in the corner. A little early to start time wasting, but it's just subtly taking off some time from the clock. That's dangerously drilled in by Gasol, the former Lewis player. Well away though on this occasion by the home side. Zoe Ness Taylor's in the centre. Ness trying to find her, almost onto the head of Taylor. Just zipped across and brushed those top hairs of the 27-year-old. But she doesn't make any contact. And it's harmlessly out for a goal kick, and more seconds tick away. 77 minutes gone, Lewis 2, Crystal Palace 3. Conti Cup action here at the Dripping Pan. Crystal Palace will make another change in just a moment as they try and shore up the game. And we'll see Leah Rutherford come on. And heading off will be the goal scorer. The opening goal scorer, Magda Masengo, another player that Lewis will be glad to see the back of.
Yeah,
Peter Rutherford in the squad, and it is a bit of a surprise that Ella Rutherford, who's more of the threat for Crystal Palace. Oh, possible handball there, and the referee says no, and that looked like a penalty when you consider the new handball rule to determine that that's unintentional. It was very generous from the official, but Lewis will get away with that. But I'm saying that we have Leta Rutherford, but Ella Rutherford from Bristol City is the real threat for Palace, but she's not even in the squad on this occasion. Meanwhile, there's problems for Lewis because the looping shot will come in from Georgiou, which goes over the bar, but out of your picture, you'll see a rather nasty looking injury to Annie Timoney, who stayed down and looks to be clutching the left ankle or maybe even heel. And unfortunately for Lewis, they've got no substitutes left either, so they might have to play the last 10 minutes or so with just 10 women. So things just not going right in these closing stages for Lewis, who haven't really recovered or wrestled back any momentum since Crystal Palace scored their third goal. But the upside is the penalty wasn't awarded. And as that cross came in from the left-hand side, there was a very strong shout of handball. It's one of those strange ones where when you look at it, it wasn't intentional, but was the hand in a natural position? Possibly not. And if it moves at all under the new handball rule, that is usually awarded a spot kick. One for VAR maybe in the future if it enters the Conte Cup, and of course the Women's Championship more broadly. But from Lewis's point of view, we can just be thankful that a spot kick wasn't given. Unfortunately though, like I say, Annie Timoney is still down. So we have a drinks break here. Hopefully Lewis will be able to get Timoney back up on her feet, because they won't want to have the final 10 minutes with just 10 women. Gives both managers the opportunity to have a little team talk, although Palace have stayed out in the centre, but Fran Alonso and also Maka giving her final words as captain. After a pulsating 80 minutes, she'll be hoping to make a mark in the final 10, and in doing so, bow out in glory. This one can't technically finish a draw, because in the Conte Cup, draws then result in penalties. So if Lewis score one, they'll have an opportunity still to win it on penalties. Fortunately though, out of your picture, Annie Timoney has been carried off. and as a consequence, we wish her well. And Lewis will have to play the final 10 minutes plus stoppage time with just 10 women. Looks to be an injury to the ankle area on the left foot, and that is elevated and raised as she's carried off to receive more medical treatment. So an unfortunate end for the Lewis defender. Hopefully the medical treatment is just precautionary and nothing is broken or serious. And if you follow Lewis FC channels across digital, they will update you on her progress over the coming hours or days. Lewis must finish this a woman down because they've made their three substitutions and now it's getting a little bit niggly. Firm challenge there coming in from the substitute Danny Lane. Georgiou for Palace has taken a knock of her own. Suddenly the game is losing a bit of its rhythm and we're going to find ourselves with a fair amount of added time, I would imagine, as well. Something in the region of 4 or more minutes. From Crystal Palace's perspective, it's exactly what they want to happen, though. One extra woman, time ticking away, momentum falling away. Looped into the box here by Palace. Goddard should be able to pick it up instead, though. She will leave the ball for Rutherford, who works the ball into the box, and there is Ladat again, who scored that spectacular goal that may prove the winner. Almost able to connect once again. Donovan now for Lewis. Well pleased by Pepper, who stood tall. Hayes trying to force it up towards Danny Lane. And Lewis just struggling to get any kind of ball in the Crystal Palace final third. Pepper's throwing down the line, gains a few yards, wastes a few seconds. 6 minutes remaining. Lewis 2, Crystal Palace 3 in the Conte Cup. This will be a big win for Palace, their first in competitive football of the season, having drawn 2 and lost 2 in the Women's Championship. And a wonderful response after losing 6-0 to Aston Villa. Ella Powell, though, trying to take this to penalties, into changes with Amy Taylor, who in her first start has scored for the first time as a Lewis FC player. Now Powell just has to hop over the advertising boardings to actually get this ball. Stadium in a prime position in the centre of Lewis, right next to the station, with banks and marshes behind us. Long throw comes in, Ness gets the flick on, Root was almost there, sliced half clear by Palace. A speculative effort. Again, handing Crystal Palace easy possession back. Palace will make their final change. Kira Sherwood will come on. Coming off will be the former Lewis player, Cheryl Castle, who scored today.
Substitution for Crystal Palace, leading the pitch, 13, Cheryl Castle. And coming on, number 8, Kiara Sherwood.
Kiara Sherwood replaces Castle. Like for like swap, although Sherwood can drop a bit deeper. She has actually wattling on the back of her shirt, which one assumes is her married name, unless there's been any form of mix-up on the team sheets, but it certainly looks and appears to be Kira Sherwood, so we'll go with that. Drilled in now, and Ladat almost there again. She's caused a real nuisance thus far, and Lewis just being forced further and further and further back, and we only have 4 minutes remaining. Palace with that extra woman after Timoney went off injured and all subs have been used, starting to dictate play and just cleverly hang on to possession. Katie McIntyre, 3.5 minutes plus injury time of her career remaining, gets the block in on that right hand side, not once but twice. Still though, Lewis can't get the ball back. Georgiou dinked up towards Sherwood. McIntyre's there and she's nudged in the back for a free kick and some welcome position to Lewis, but not in a threatening area. And they're going to have to start taking some risks here, Lewis, and get the ball forwards quickly, or it will be a first defeat of the season. Root, who's made some threatening runs, but hasn't often received the ball. On this occasion, she goes alone down the centre in an intrepid run, but just tried to do a little bit too much. And Palace again can just pass the ball into the corner, and even if they don't win it, they continue to just push Lewis back. And it will be a Crystal Palace throw-in as well. Referee just telling the visitors to get a move on. Pepper looks tired though, she's probably running as fast as she can, almost limping. There's certainly some tired legs by the visitors, who have done really well here to, as you'd expect, be competitive but also bounce back after almost every Lewis goal. Nadat's gone down in a lot of pain there, clutching her right knee. There was no whistle though. It will be another Crystal Palace throw-in as we await the board for injury time with 90 seconds or so remaining. And if you add this injury to Ladat, who could prove the winning goal scorer, and what a goal to win a game as well, if you tack this on to the other injuries, particularly Timoney's, we must have at least 4 minutes of added time. So still a bit of hope for Lewis, and they only need one goal to stand a chance here, because 3-3 then takes it to penalties in the Conte Cup. Dat is up now, Pepper with the throw. Receives the ball back from the substitute Rutherford. Ladat, another sub, just keeping it in the corner once again. Finally the ball goes out and it will be a goal kick to Lewis. 30 seconds remaining before that board goes up. McIntyre. It's going to be emotional for her, even if Lewis lose. No doubt she'll receive a guard of honour as she leaves the field for the final time. Long ball down the line. Root is almost there. Pepper's down on the ground this time. She's taken a heavy knock. It's a head injury, so no chances can be taken here. 7 minutes added time, so plenty of opportunity still for Lewis.
7 minutes of additional time.
Realistically, that's going to be closer to 8, because the 7 minutes went up just as this treatment to Pepper started.
Please, everybody stick around. This is when we'll be doing a very special presentation to Katie McIntyre. Thank you.
Daybreak, the director at Lewis FC, there'll be a special on-field presentation to Katie McIntyre as well, the captain of Lewis, who's retiring after this game. 7 minutes pretty much start now, and we've already had about 45 seconds of extra time, so they'll be closer to 8. And Lewis finally have the ball in a dangerous area. It's going to be a free kick right by the corner flag. McIntyre is forwards, wearing 4 at the back post. The bigger defender next to her is Caitlin Hayes. Noble to deliver. Root, the substitute, on the edge of the area. Are we going to have a fairy tale here where Maka scores? She's at the back post, as is Ness as well. She now moves towards the penalty spot, but Noble hesitates. Understandably, plenty of Lewis shirts in the box. Here we go, after that hesitation with take 2. It is Noble to deliver it. over the head of McIntyre. Ness brushed the ball slightly. Taylor can't pick it up, but Root, who switched sides to the left, is able to keep this attack going. But just lost her balance a little bit. Noble, the free kick taker from the halfway line. A little bit short on that occasion as she looked for Caitlin Hayes. Hayes once more. Lewis have to be direct now. Fired down the line into a dangerous area. Ness might get there. Ness just about staying onside after she received the ball from Donovan. And then the substitute, Danny Lane, is clipped. And here's a free kick in a dangerous position. Here's a free kick in a shooting or crossing position. And it's another chance for McIntyre to come forwards in the final seconds of her professional football career. Noble again, setting up to cross. 3-1 in Crystal Palace wall, needs to be a bit further back than that. And they do finally take those steps back. Ella Powell is totally unmarked down the right-hand side if Noble fancies a little decoy, but she's only looking in the box at the moment, and Noble will now deliver it. That's a dangerous ball and a header coming in. Lewis asking for a corner, but I think the final touch may have been off Ness, who continues to stare down Emma Gibbon and ask for a corner instead of a goal kick, but Gibbon just happy to take her time and release the ball. And now we only have about 4 minutes remaining. Crystal Palace deserve credit. Odat, who looks like being the winning goal scorer, to Georgiou. She can't spread the ball to Rutherford though. And McIntyre again will come away with the ball. Danny Lane goes backwards to Izzy Foster. And the time running out, Lewis can't afford to just pass the ball neatly across the back. Crystal Palace will let them do that all day. It is fired down the line, but that is a difficult ball for Root to control, and Rutherford will work it up towards the excellent Ashley Goddard. Palace captain loses out on this occasion though. Taylor, that's a neat ball down the left-hand side. Here is Ella Powell storming into the area. A cutback would have given a real opportunity there to Emily Donovan. Instead, Ella Powell must settle for a corner as the referee, Alex Bradley, looks at his watch for the first time. Emma Noble trotting over, really sprinting over to take this corner, and forwards again comes McIntyre. Hayes as well is up there. She's the biggest of those defenders. And another target might be Danny Lane. Maybe one last chance for Lewis here to take this to penalties. Donovan is right in front of the goalkeeper, as is Ness. Noble to deliver, Root on the edge of the area. McIntyre by the penalty spot. It comes up towards McIntyre. Hayes gets a header, but she's taken a blow there to the nose and will stop play due to a head injury. I think she collided with her own player, although there's a Palace player down as well. And instantly you could see that Caitlin Hayes had taken a blow to the nose, and McIntyre the first to check she's okay. Those two may have in fact collided. And in that melee, more time runs down, and this does indeed look like being a Crystal Palace win in the Conte Cup and Lewis's first defeat of the season. Around a minute remaining by my watch, plus whatever stoppage is added on here. Crystal Palace with a morale-boosting win if the scoreline stays the same. And their hero is Ria Ladat, the substitute, who scored from about 20 yards out into the top left-hand corner. It was a super finish, one worthy of winning any game.
Just to say, today's match attendance is 341.
341 is the match attendance as well.
Countless people around the world as well. Thank you.
And if you are listening on the stream, you've just had a thank you on the Tannoy as well for doing that. Thanks in particular to those that are at our streaming party in New York. And do send us photos of that. In fact, from wherever you're watching, take a photograph, post a picture. And stick around on the stream as well, because we'll have the post-match presentation marking the career of Katie McIntyre, and she'll leave the field to a guard of honour. It looks, unfortunately, like Caitlin Hayes might miss that, because she may have to depart the field early, and Lewis are already down to 10 women, and sadly the stretcher is coming out. I suspect this might be a fractured or a broken nose, given the way she went down and immediately clutched the top of the nose and that area in between the eyes. And unfortunately, this is another nasty injury, having already lost Annie Timoney. So an entertaining afternoon, but at the end of the day, cup defeat and two big players injured as well. Some positives though, including a first goal for Amy Taylor. The other Lewis scorer was the in-form Zoe Ness, who got the late winner against Coventry City last time out in the league. We actually are going to be close to a 100-minute football match here as well. 7 minutes of added time plus this injury. So when you total all that up, it's been a long and bruising afternoon for Lewis. But unless anything dramatic changes, is going to end in defeat. So sadly, the last action as a Lewis FC player for Katie McIntyre is to put the leg straps on a colleague and defensive partner of hers. Caitlin Harris is going to be stretchered off here. Annie Timoney has already been taken off with what looked to be some kind of bruised, broken or fractured ankle. And Lewis and their medical staff will have to confirm the severity of both injuries. Of course, with head injuries, there is protocol as well, so one hopes that this is more concussion protocol than anything serious, but just the way that she fell and immediately clutched that nose area suggests, unfortunately, that something facial around the nose, in between the eyes or cheek area, might be quite severely damaged here. And there's certainly a lot of concern amongst the Lewis FC players. Charlie Dobray just joins me briefly now. This is an unfortunate end, really, and having lost Timoney, and with Hayes now down, it's proven quite a bruising encounter, Charlie.
It has. I mean, one thing people know about women's football you watch it is it's full-blooded, and that if someone stays on the ground, they're hurt, because these women always get up, even after those crunching tackles. So we're just waiting to see what happens now.
Of course, we wish Caitlin Hayes well, but in a perverse way, even though we don't want to be talking about injuries, Charlie, it again illustrates the worth of Katie McIntyre, who was first there on scene playing physio alongside captain, putting on all the straps, helping lift the stretcher. That's the kind of player and character she is.
That's right. I mean, you know, looking after the other players is number one. That's the job of the captain, and she'll always be first in there. We're just sort of waiting to see at the moment when the stretcher can move, but I think maybe a bit more of a longer stoppage still.
So, unfortunately, a lot of the momentum and jubilation has been taken out of the closing stages here, and the health of Caitlin Harris far more important than the result. And there's a lot of concerned players as she departs here. Hopefully the stretcher is a precaution. Hopefully down there she's talking and making some signals, and at least suggesting that she might be okay, but as she passes us here, we'll be able to get a better look. And there's not, unfortunately, much movement of the hands or too much signal, although there is enough to at least tell us that she's not unconscious. But this is a sad end, and she gets a standing ovation and will immediately be taken for more medical treatment. And nice to see the Crystal Palace fans as well showing their concern alongside the players on the field. So Lewis now are down to 9 women, and they have about a minute to try and find a miraculous equaliser to take this to penalties. The referee looks at his watch again, Alex Bradley. Play will restart now. I think both teams are just trying to determine who should have the ball to begin with. I think Palace are arguing it was a cross, it was a collision, and it's a 50-50 ball. It'll be dropped in front of the goalkeeper, Emma Gibbon, and she'll just hang on to it for possibly the final seconds here. Don't forget, though, on a positive note, there is still that presentation ceremony to mark the career of Katie McIntyre. Ball goes long, and we enter into the final minute now, and Palace just pump it long, and that will reach Izzy Foster. So hard, though, when you've only got 9 women to have any kind of shape in the closing stages. Heavy first touch by Root. Palace again will clear their lines. Is there time for one last Lewis chance? Georgiou trying to stop that eventuality in towards Goddard. She was almost through. You can see the space though now with a 2-woman advantage. Ladat choosing to cross it rather than put it in the corner. And it will be a corner kick to Crystal Palace, and that should just about see out the match. Macca getting in the way. So her last contribution was a vital defensive interception to stop it being 4-2, but unfortunately in conceding the corner, that's probably going to do it time-wise, because our 7 added minutes are now up. It all just depends what the referee wants to add on now after that head injury to Caitlin Hayes. Rita Ladat is in the corner, and that's another Crystal Palace throw-in. We've played well over 100 minutes now. Thanks for joining us wherever you are watching all over the world. Stay with the stream for the post-match, including that presentation to Macca. And there is the full-time whistle. Lewis FC with their first defeat of the season. Lewis 2, Crystal Palace 3 in the Conte Cup. A match marred in the end by 2 injuries, neither intentional, but both of them brutal enough to mean Annie Timoney and, most concerningly, Caitlin Hayes had to leave the field. Hayes on a stretcher, not moving too much, possibly with a broken nose. So Lewis finishing the game with 9 women. Rhea Ladat, though, scored a stunning goal from 20 yards into the top left-hand corner, and that proved the match winner, just as Lewis had made it 2-2 and looked like having all the momentum in the final 20 minutes. Crystal Palace, though, looked organised. They were resolute. And it's the first win of the season for Dean Davenport's side. The other scorers for Palace, Cheryl Castle and Magda Masengo. And Palace never trailed in the game. For Lewis, Zoe Ness had equalised at 1-1. Amy Taylor with a neat finish, lifted over the goalkeeper at 2-2. But immediately afterwards, Rael Adapt with the winner. What a goal it was. Crystal Palace have the win in the Conte Cup. Lewis with their first defeat of the season. Full time from the dripping pan. Lewis 2, Crystal Palace 3. Thanks for joining myself, Ben Jacobs. And just stay with me for the next 5 minutes or so as we bring you the guard of honour for Lewis FC captain Katie Macca McIntyre, who has now returned as a professional footballer. And Lewis will pay their respects with a guard of honour. And also on the stream, we'll be giving you some post-match as well. So do stay with me.
Yeah.
So welcome back to post-match here from the Dripping Pan with myself, Ben Jacobs. Thanks in particular to those of you watching our streaming party in New York. Take plenty of photos and get involved on social media. Thanks to Maggie Murphy and Charlie Dobre for joining us throughout the commentary. Unfortunately, Lewis have lost in the Conte Cup. If you have just tuned in for the closing stages, 3-2 defeated by Crystal Palace. Real Adapt with the winner. Make sure you see the goal though. It was an absolutely wonderful strike from 20 yards into the top left-hand corner. So Crystal Palace will warm down with their first win of the season. Lewis defeated for the first time, and unfortunately we've had two quite severe injuries as well, most notably to Caitlin Harris, who went off with some form of head injury. We understand it might be a broken nose and she'll be checked under concussion protocol as well. Amy Timoney also came off with an injury, which means Lewis finished the game with 9 women. Hers less serious, but she was still carried off with that left foot elevated. It may well be a bruised or fractured ankle. But now we go back to the field for the walk-off parade for Lewis FC captain, who is now retiring. And let's soak in the atmosphere as for the last time leaving the field, it is Katie McIntyre. And she'll be presented with various accolades as well when leaving the field.
I just want to sing on time in the way. This is such a small token from everybody at the club. 4 roses for the number 4, because we love them. A fantastic picture by the ever amazing James Boys. And There are no words, but I'm going to, if you don't mind, Mac, you can just say a few, you don't want to say anything, that's totally understandable. Mac has been here for 9 seasons, I think it is, and if you haven't read the notes in our programme, on my programme, please do, because you'll just see what an incredible career she's had. And I mean, people talk about modern professionals and legends, they overuse that term. We've been incredibly fortunate at this club to have this star on the pitch, who, as you know, if you've been coming year in, year out, gives absolutely everything for this team and for this club, and it's something that everybody on the pitch and off the pitch can learn from, there's no doubt. Kate, we sadly wish you a happy retirement, whatever comes, and we hope that you're going to be around somehow or other, but thank you so, so much. This is a gift from us. Thank you.
Katie McIntyre receiving a warm ovation, and nice to see Ashley Goddard, the Crystal Palace captain, as well, giving her an embrace. I'm wishing her a happy retirement. So Katie McIntyre walks off for the final time. We wish her well in her retirement. Standing ovation from everybody involved at Lewis FC. She greets her family, who have made their way to the central part of the main stand. Hopefully, from Lewis's point of view, she will choose to stay involved in the club in some capacity. But an emotional end to a thrilling encounter. Unfortunately, as the drums start again, Lewis have been defeated for the first time this season. We thank you for your company. Hopefully we'll get to stream again throughout the course of the season. We'll also be talking just before we go off air to Fran Alonso as well. For myself, Ben Jacobs, as far as the commentary is concerned, thank you for listening. And we'll now get some post-match on our stream as well. Delighted to say that as the drums pound, we are joined by Lewis FC manager Fran Alonso. Lewis losing 3-2 to Crystal Palace in the Conti Cup this afternoon. Frank, thanks very much for joining me. That was a bruising encounter, and unfortunately Lewis falling to their first defeat. Give us your thoughts.
I think we were very poor in the first half. Some players came for the first time into the team, and our shape wasn't the one we wanted, the one we wanted. Concede 2 goals, quite easy. It was easy for Palace to play out. And we changed a little bit in the second half. We scored the goal. I thought we would go back into the game, but we were really unfortunate to concede the third one in another mistake. And yeah, it definitely was probably our worst performance, and something to work on. Very sad day for us as well. Maka retiring, and we just lost 2 players. Annie broken ankle in a tackle, and Kevin in a concussion. Not very positive day for us.
Yeah, we'll talk about Maka in just a moment, but as far as the injuries are concerned, so you can confirm, or we certainly think early suggestions, that Timothy's ankle is broken. And was Hayes a blow to the nose or the facial area?
Timothy got broken ankle, it's confirmed. They just
The treatment room.
Let's talk about Maka in a bit more detail. Just tell me how influential she's been to you since joining the club as captain, as a dressing room figure, as we saw with the injury in the end, as a sort of physio, first person over there, helping strap up and everything. She's going to be missed in a lot of different areas.
Yeah, definitely. She's a captain, a role model, somebody who we love. But because of that, we need to spare her position and support her. Obviously, it's going to be missed. All the players love her, staff love her, and it will be missed, of course. But I'm sure she will be soon joining us in a different role in the end, but hopefully we'll get her back soon.
Of course, in the Cup, managers like yourself this afternoon tend to make a few changes. You brought in a couple of people that got their first starts. Amy Butler got on the score sheet. Zoe Ness scored again as well. So just talk to me about some of the positives.
The positive is we could give some minutes to some players that didn't have until now. Opportunity for some players to make an impact and maybe get into the team sheet the following week. The positives are that, but I think overall we are not happy. The final result obviously disappointed, but for me mainly is that we didn't play our football, that was our worst game, and we make it very easy for Palace, especially in the first half. So we have to review the game and try to correct these mistakes, because we should be much better than we were today.
Just finally, looking forward, still unbeaten, of course, in the Women's Championship. And sometimes you can lose a game like this, can't you? And it can actually be a positive, because in the league it gives everybody a little bit of a kick. And I guess that's what you're hoping for over the coming weeks, that the loss leads to an immediate response. And obviously you continue the unbeaten run in the league as a result.
Yeah, we're priority number one in the league, so if we have to lose a game, I prefer to lose today, of course. Next week we will go there. I'm sure we will be much better than we were today, and we are going to try to get the 3 points, of course, like every other game. I really believe in the group. Obviously, everyone can have off days. I believe in this group. I believe in the talent we got. I believe in the great organization that we have shown in every game. Although today we didn't, but yeah, I'm sure we will pick it up from here, and we will be much, much better in the next game.
Great stuff, Frank. Thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed to Fran Alonso, Lewis FC manager full-time. Then Lewis's first defeat of the season in the Conte Cup. They've lost by 3-2 to Crystal Palace. We thank you for watching all over the world, and we look forward to further coverage over the course of the season in both the Cup and the league. From Fran and myself, Ben Jacobs, to all of you watching all over the world, it is good evening.
Thanks, mate. Much appreciated. Cheers.
Talking.
Yeah, it's weird, isn't it?
horrible. Like, Dakar, broken ankle. This is nothing for that.